Yes, after knowing the
qualitative analysis as well as the quantitative analysis of elements present in the organic molecule, the next part before of us is the identification of the structure of organic compound. What is its molecular formula? That we know. After knowing the molecular formula, what is its structure? That is, what are the functional groups present in it, whether it is having saturation or unsaturation. What is its molecular structural connectivities is a issue, a topic that is before of us. Thus here, after knowing the qualitative analysis as well as the quantitative analysis, the next is from the percentages of the atoms of the elements present in the organic molecule, we will identify the empirical formula as well as molecular formula with the given weight. And further, structural analysis is present. The structural analysis mainly consisting of information from the unsaturations and the saturations, followed by functional group information. And functional groups are majorly divided into two categories as per the analysis is concerned. First variety is general functional groups, that is not having any kind of nitrogen. And second one is nitrogen containing functional groups. And with this, followed by solubility help, generally we will predict the structure associated with the organic molecules. Let us go for the unsaturation, that is degree of unsaturation. It is also known as double bond equivalence. Then what is meant by double bond equivalence? And from a organic molecule of different elemental combination, what is the generalized formula for the calculation of degree of unsaturation? What is its meaning? And if different elements are present, what is the generalized formula? What is the segregated formula for the calculation of degree of unsaturation, otherwise the double bond equivalence of organic molecule? We will discuss, then we will go for the further discussions related to the analysis of functional groups. Saturated hydrocarbon, the hydrocarbon, that is carbons and the hydrogen combination in which all sp3 hybridizations of carbons are there, and everywhere carbon-carbon single connectivities are there, such kind of all things are said to be saturated hydrocarbons, because you won't find any kind of double bonds, triple bonds, etc. Hence these of all are saturated hydrocarbons. If I go for the unsaturated hydrocarbons, carbon followed by carbon connected with at least a double bond or a triple bond, those of all are said to be unsaturated hydrocarbons. And here there is a special case. Suppose if I am having an alkene system like this, whereas this particular portion carbon-carbon connected by double bond, if this double bond is having another one carbon in it, otherwise you write this one as it is, this is the case, whereas I am writing another case, these are the carbons, here another one carbon is present, and this is the case where expecting there are another two carbons are present, and this is the case where we are expecting three other carbons in the mid of two carbon atoms. That is, double bond can be converted in the form of ring. So therefore, ring is also one variety of unsaturation, which is equal to another one extra pi bond present in the system. So therefore, ring and double bond both are same. Ring and double bond as for unsaturation is concerned, both are equal to one another. So therefore, every pi bond is one unsaturation, and at the same time, every ring is also equal to one unsaturation. Hence, it is also renamed as the double bond equivalence, is also known as ring equivalence, and commonly it is said to be what? Unsaturation equivalence. Unsaturation equivalence is nothing but the total number of double bonds, or double to the number of triple bonds, or a combination of double bonds and triple bonds, followed by number of times of rings present in the organic molecules, is known as its unsaturation equivalence. A brief view related to the unsaturation and the counting of unsaturation, that is unsaturation equivalence. In organic molecules, every time carbon-carbon connectivities may not be present, carbon followed by other atoms are there, and unsaturation may be present with respect to the just other atoms combinations also. Let us go for the carbon and carbon combinations, and in organic molecules we may come across carbon and carbon are having just single bonds. There is no double bonds, like a system where everywhere carbon and carbon is connected by just sp3 hybridized carbon versus carbon sigma bond formation can occur. Sometimes double bond, sometimes triple bond, double and triple bond combination, just rings, rings followed by double bonds, rings followed by triple bonds, rings followed by double and triple bonds. Every variety of combination is present. And in this case, in the first case, there is no unsaturation, hence the double bond equivalence. By looking at the structure, double bond equivalence will become equal to 0. Whereas in the second case, one pi bond is there, hence double bond equivalence is 1. And here, two pi bonds are there, hence double bond equivalence is 2. And in this case, one triple bond, that is 1 plus 1 and one double bond, total 3 is there, hence the double bond equivalence or the ring equivalence or the unsaturation equivalence will become equal to 3. 3 stands for it is lack of 6 hydrogens to reach the saturated hydrocarbon, that is alkane system CnH2n plus 2. And here ring system, one ring stands for one double bond, so therefore double bond equivalence is 1. Here also overall it is 4 carbons, but it is present in ring system, hence here also it is lack of one double bond, so therefore to get the saturation it is less by 2 hydrogens, 1 double bond equivalence, hence unsaturation equivalence will become equal to 1. Ring is 1, double bond is 1, 1 plus 1, 2. Here ring is 1, double bond is 1 and triple bond is 2, that will become equal to 1 plus 1 plus 2, that will become equal to 4. Thus, carbon and the carbon primary chemical combinations may have saturation, may have unsaturation, and corresponding equivalent of unsaturation present in the organic molecules is, with respect to every ring, unsaturation equivalence is 1. With respect to every pi bond, unsaturation equivalence is equal to 1. Thus, unsaturations, by looking at the structure, you can calculate. And every unsaturation gives the information that to reach the alkane structure of the same number of carbons, it is lacked by 2 hydrogens. Theoretically, unsaturation equivalence present in the organic molecule, if it is allowed to react with the same many number of hydrogen molecules, it is converted to saturated non-cyclic hydrocarbon. That is, unsaturated equivalence of hydrocarbon is, suppose some X, unsaturated equivalence is X, unsaturated hydrocarbon, let us consider here, and its equivalence is here X, unsaturated equivalence is, suppose if it is X, then on theoretical reaction with X molecules of hydrogen, it is converted to saturated non-cyclic hydrocarbon with the formula CnH2n plus 2. The second case of unsaturation, that is carbon chemical combination with the other atoms like hetero atoms, if they are properly combined with multiple bonds, then unsaturation will result. Suppose carbon and the nitrogen, if it forms a triple bond system, else it can form a double bond system like imine system also, like double bond system, triple bond system, single bond system. In single bond system we won't find any kind of unsaturation, but in double bond system, triple bond system, we will be facing unsaturations. And at the same time, carbon with the oxygen hetero atom like aldehydes, acids, esters, anhydrides, C followed by double bond O, if it forms single bond system, then there is no unsaturation. Similar to that of oxygen family, sulfur also forms the unsaturation. And halogen, when combines, it is monovalent, it doesn't have ability to form multiple bonds, hence there is no unsaturation. And argent also offers the unsaturation. Even hetero atoms combination in between them also offers unsaturations, like here argents, that is diazo compounds, diazonium compounds, and nitroso compounds, nitro compounds, these of all will offers corresponding unsaturations as per the chemical combination and the number of pi bonds. We can calculate the unsaturations present in the molecular structures. And if they are connected with, once again, any ring system, as being it is the part of ring system, otherwise ring is the part of this structure, then also unsaturation may enhances. Let us go for the formula, generalized formula used for calculation of unsaturation. Here I am taking a simple examples of all varieties of homo combinations as well as the hetero combinations present in the organic molecules, otherwise generally reoccurring in the organic molecules. Carbon connected with just hydrogens, a single carbon, And here I want to write something from the nitrogen family. So I wrote the by replacing the three hydrogens by one nitrogen. I wrote from the oxygen chemical combination relevant information by replacing two hydrogens by one oxygen, which is the double bond, and one hydrogen replacement by the halogen atom. You may consider it as chlorine, bromine, any other things. Now, in the first case, that is a saturated hydrocarbon alkane system having molecular formula CH4 and the tentative generalized formula for the alkane CnH2n+2. From that help, we have to write that it is having 0 as the double bond equivalence. So, therefore, here number of carbons and the number of hydrogens help has to be taken. It is having the unsaturation equivalence as 0. That 0 should come from the carbons and the hydrogens information. Whereas hydrogens by number are 4, carbons by number are 1. So, therefore, to make it 0, one has to be subtracted from the other. So, therefore, carbon help as well as the hydrogen help has to be taken. And here, generally that unsaturation's reference is carbon. From carbon, if I calculate, that becomes easy because the hetero atom can be of any other atom. Yes, any hetero atom can be there, hydrogen can be there. So, therefore, carbons and the hydrogens combinations help. This has to be taken for the positive quantity, this has to be taken for the negative quantity to make it in the form of formula. To formulate the unsaturation equivalence, we are taking carbon and the hydrogen numbers help. In such a way, carbon as reference main, because that is basic, and carbon followed by hydrogen as a negative quantity we are taking here. To make it 0 here, what I am taking is number of carbons plus 1. If I take, then it will becomes equal to minus number of hydrogens by 2. See here, hydrogen number is 4. 4 times stands for what? And tentative formulation of all alkanes related unsaturation equivalence, I came to know that such kind of formula tentatively will work. That is number of carbons plus 1 minus whatever the number of hydrogens are there. If I divide that one into half, so this quantity will becomes equal to half. Whereas this half, that is 4 half will becomes equal to 2. To make it 0 here, carbons are added by another one number. This formula will work for entire alkane family. Hence, the general formula can be given by number of carbons plus 1 plus minus of number of hydrogens by 2 will results the double bond equivalence, that is carbons plus 1 is 1 plus 1 plus 0 minus number of hydrogens, 4 by 2, 4 by 2 is 2, 2 minus 2 will become equal to how much here, 0. Hence, the generalized formula used for the calculation of unsaturation equivalence present in the hydrocarbons is consisting of just carbons and the hydrogens. Yes, number of carbons plus 1 plus minus of number of hydrogens by 2 will results the formula for the calculation of unsaturation present in the organic molecule. This formula appears as number of carbon present in the hydrocarbon plus 1 plus minus 1 times of number of hydrogens by 2. Cn plus 1 plus minus number of hydrogens by 2 will results the double bond equivalence of the hydrocarbon. Let us go for the case, suppose if hydrogen is replaced by the halogen atom, then in that case how to calculate the double bond equivalence. Hydrogen is also monovalent, similar to that of the halogen is also monovalent, similar to that of the hydrogen, halogen also forms one single connectivity. Hence, you can count this one as hydrogen itself. So, therefore, the unsaturation equivalence can becomes equal to carbon plus 1 plus, yes, minus 1 times of number of hydrogens plus number of halogens total by 2 will results equal to the unsaturation equivalence. Thus, unsaturation equivalence with respect to carbon, hydrogen followed by halogen combination can also be calculated. Yes, double bond equivalence with respect to the presence of hetero atom like oxygen. If oxygen is there, then before this is methane. In this methane, if two hydrogens are replaced by one oxygen atom, then it results into the formaldehyde. So, therefore, here from methane it is going to be obtained. How it is going to be obtained? By replacing two hydrogens followed by one oxygen atom is substituted over there. Thus, it results into the formaldehyde. Thus, whenever oxygen comes, oxygen is equal to replacement of two hydrogens. By removing two hydrogens, one oxygen came into the structure. Else in some other cases, what happens? Oxygen atom comes and inserted in the structure without changing any kind of saturations and the unsaturations present in the molecule. Suppose if it is converted to acid like this, then what happens? From here to here, what makes the difference? Whatever the oxygen atom came in the mid, it is present as it is. It is not at all changing any kind of saturations and the unsaturations present in the original, this particular structure and this structure. Thus, when oxygen comes, what happens? Oxygen is coming when it is associated with the unsaturation. It is equal to replacement of how many hydrogens? Two hydrogens. Two hydrogens equal to how many bonds? One bond, that is one double bond equivalency is extra expected due to the presence of oxygen. Hence, the formula is modified in such a way that the equivalence, double bond equivalence will become equal to C plus 1, yes, that we wrote in the beginning, plus yes, oxygen coming, commencement of oxygen results removal of two hydrogens in the structure itself. Whereas, hydrogen amount is subtracted from the system. So, therefore, two hydrogen atoms are subtracted, that is minus 2, minus of minus will become equal to, that is by 2, that will become equal to 1, unsaturation is enhanced by 1 unit, hence oxygen count is not taken. So C plus 1 plus 0 minus number of hydrogens by 2 is the valid formula in case of oxygen is associated in the organic molecule for the calculation of DBU, that is double bond equivalence or unsaturation equivalence. Yes, when heteroatom like nitrogen is present from the normal hydrocarbon, nitrogen presence is expected by replacing three hydrogens followed by introduction of another one nitrogen atom in the structure. So therefore, nitrogen generally forms three connectivities. So three connectivities are different from the carbon, which is where carbon is forming four connectivities. So therefore, formula variation will occur. And here, out of these three hydrogens replacement, one extra atom is added, that is nitrogen. Hence, we are taking the help of nitrogen as well as the hydrogen count to calculate the formula, otherwise to make the tentative relation for the double bond equivalence. Hence, in this case, the double bond equivalence can be given by number of carbons plus 1 plus number of nitrogens minus number of hydrogens by 2. This is the generalized formula used for the calculation of double bond equivalence. Here in this case, what happened? Let us have a look. Here three hydrogens are less. Yes, three hydrogens are less, followed by one nitrogen is extra. So therefore, three hydrogens are less implies minus 3. Minus 3 followed by what? Here one nitrogen is extra. Nitrogen here I am adding here. So therefore, that is minus 3 plus 1. That will become equal to plus 2. So here plus 2 by 2, that will become equal to extra 1 is there. Extra 1 followed by Cn plus 1. 1 extra here we are adding, that will result equal to the total number of unsaturations present in the organic molecule. In this case, that will become equal to number of carbons 1 followed by 1, whereas number of nitrogens 1, number of hydrogens 1. So therefore, this will become equal to 1 minus 1 by 2, 0, 1 plus 1 becomes equal to what? 2 pi bonds are present in the system. Thus, this can be applied for all nitrogen related family. Similarly, oxygen families, for all oxygen and oxygen related family, that formula that we made the discussion, and the halogen related family, the first formula is applicable. Hence, we can write a most generalized formula validating for the heteroatoms presence like nitrogen family elements, oxygen family elements, as well as halogen family elements. That generalized formula appears as like this. Yes, the double bond equivalence, which is also known as DBE, will become equal to total number of carbons present in the organic molecule, Cn, number of carbon atoms, plus 1, plus is 0 times of number of oxygens, hence it is not counted. Oxygen, not only oxygen and sulfurs, oxygen family elements, plus 1 times of number of nitrogen and the family elements, either nitrogen or the phosphorus, or nitrogen and the phosphorus combination, minus number of hydrogens, minus number of halogens, divided by 2 results the number. That number will become equal to double bond equivalence. It results either number of double bonds are half to the number of triple bonds and a combination of double and triple bonds followed by an association of number of rings present in the structure which is known as DBE, that is double bond equivalence. Calculate the double bond equivalence present in the structure. Yes, as per the structure is concerned, it is having a benzene ring structure having of three double bonds over here followed by one ring. Nitro group is having one double bond, oxime is having one double bond, and here one double bond is there. Yes, such kind of structural features are appearing in this. Thereby, by looking at the structure, you can calculate. But go for the molecular formula of the structure. Apply the relation, that is number of carbons plus one plus of number of nitrogens minus number of hydrogens minus number of halogens by 2 to calculate the total amount of unsaturation, total number of double bond equivalences. How many number of, if I assume all unsaturations as double bonds, how many number of double bond equivalent features are there? You calculate as per the formula is concerned.